The city of Sydney itself is the county seat of Shelby County, Ohio. About an hour north of Dayton, Ohio, the city itself has a full-time population of around 22,000, but we have a unique workforce population of 35,000. Hello, my name is Brad Jones, and I'm the fire chief in the city of Sydney, Ohio. We've established a partnership with Underwriter Laboratories, Firefighters Safety Research Institute. And it's been an awesome opportunity to expose not only our organization, but regional departments to the experiments that Underwriter Laboratories have been doing.
What is good fire service coordination? How do we pair up ventilation with suppression for the best outcome for the victim? What are the options for where your stream goes and how you ventilate that structure that can wind up to be the most effective? We're going to answer these questions and more as part of this coordinated fire attack study.
The importance of studying a coordinated fire attack is critical. The American Fire Service up to now, through any textbook, there's really no exact definition of what a coordinated fire attack is. So it's critical that we, the fire service, look to become better, taking the experience from the streets and mixing it with science and true data on when, where, and why do we apply water, and then how do we vent before, during, or after to make that the best, not only for property conservation, fire suppression, but most importantly, to save civilian lives more so in the future than we ever have in the past.
The other important thing that we want to build on is we're taking the research out of the laboratory, out into the field, working with the fire service to burn acquired structures to get that additional realism.
So when you remove yourself from the lab, you increase the number of variables in an experiment. So it becomes a significant challenge to figure out how can we limit variables to allow scientific comparisons, but at the same time include all the variables we want of fire extending into structures, different size rooms, and involving the local fire department. With assistance from our tech panel, we picked tactics that could be useful all across the US.
The technical panel brings in the actual street to the science. They season the science with some reality, and the fact is we get a better study because of it, because it is more realistic. They do look at a cross-section of the United States. They look for departments big and small. This way we have a fairly well-rounded committee membership, and the nice thing is we learn from other members about their particular circumstances and how they operate. We try to find all the problems and iron them out beforehand, and that just makes for a better validated study.
Behind me, this is a real house with real furnishings. It's gonna rain today, and you can't get any more real than what's going on here. It's real fuel packages, beds, couches, curtains, and it's real ignition, it's real fire growth, and it's real water application. So I asked the American Fire Service to open up and truly see what's going on, because there's some serious stuff going on here with very educated individuals that they want true answers on how we can be better.
In the house on Water Street, we looked to the differences between vertical ventilation over the fire versus ventilation over the stairway. Then we transitioned to North Walnut, where we looked at transitional attack and how to sequence that with different ventilation characteristics such as positive pressure, horizontal, and no ventilation. We then moved to Broadway, where we studied kitchen fires, looking at transitional attack in a smaller kitchen in the rear of the house with additional horizontal ventilation. And then up to Wapakoneta, where we looked at the differences between interior tack and post-ventilation tactics of positive pressure, additional horizontal ventilation, and hydraulic ventilation.
Without the data, this becomes just a demonstration. And I think adding that level of instrumentation and data really allows us to quantify the fire ground versus just watching the fire ground. A lot of firefighter tactics have been often driven by experiences or anecdotes or just passed down from the previous generation. Sometimes those tactics and those anecdotes are accurate descriptions, sometimes they're incomplete descriptions. And quantifying the fire grounds allows us to tell the firefighters what they've always believed or sometimes change their mind on how they've always thought fire interacts with their tactics.
Using our instrumentation, we can look at things such as heat flux, pressure, and temperature. Combined together with instrumentation from the Illinois Fire Service Institute, this whole complement of instrumentation allows us to look holistically at the benefits of coordinating our suppression tactics with ventilation in the effort to understand further firefighting tactics.
So we have three main aspects of the study that we're focusing on here. Skin burns through a pig skin assessment system, as well as a laser-based moisture system, and then the hydrogen cyanide, which really complements the carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and oxygen sensors that UL typically uses.
We're also instrumenting firefighters with custom-built helmets, so we can capture what the firefighter's exposed to, and we can map then their exposures to the fire ground and really tell them kind of what it is that they're fighting inside that house.
Beaver Creek Township is a suburb of the city of Dayton, neighbor to Wright-Patterson Air Force Base in southwestern Ohio. We have a population of approximately 52,000. It's primarily a bedroom community. There's a mixture of light industry, a lot of retail, and a lot of work associated with Wright-Patterson Air Force Base. Welcome to Beaver Creek Fire Department. I am Deputy Chief Scott Dorson. We have had the good fortune to partner with UL, FSRI, and IFSI for these experiments for coordinated fire attack in residential structures.
So it'll be attack crew Keith, vent crew Jack, backup crew Mike, rig crew Richard. Just quick review of the scenario. Interior attack on a kitchen fire in the back. We'll let the fire go to flashover. Then the front door will get opened. 10 seconds after the front door, the front pane window is going to be taken out. And then 10 seconds later, the attack crew is going in for suppression.
Five, four, three, two, one, ignition.
When smoke detectors fail, fire prevention fails, it comes down to how coordinated is our fire attack when XYZ fire department pulls up based on where we stretch our line, how we apply our water, when, where, and why we vent, and when, where, and why do we search based on what we feel is survivable space.
What is most impressive about out here is just the overall coordination it takes to make it all happen.
It's very important for us to be able to have fire service partners, such as the Sydney Fire Department, to be able to come out into the field and do these tasks.
Without the support of the Beaver Creek Township Fire Department, we'd never be able to accomplish such great work for the fire service.
Ultimately, without their partnership, we aren't able to get these structures. We can't do it on our own.
I think it's been great for our folks to see how deep the research can go.
As a firefighter, we study UL, we look into their experiments, and it drives what we do. So to actually get to participate in their experiment, it's been a pretty phenomenal experience.
I've learned so much, and I'm hoping that the way we are doing our tactics now can change to help save more lives, because this is what it's all about. It's about saving firefighters, it's about saving the occupants inside.
As we wrap up this series of experiments in Ohio, the research team is going to go back to the office and pour through millions of data points and hundreds of hours of video to look for what we learned, take that data, work with our technical panel to make sure that we can have the results from this really hit the street and have an impact on firefighter safety and effectiveness.